In this webcast, we're going to talk generally about the molecular orbital interactions between either a nucleophile or an electrophile and a molecule that's in its S1 excited state. The molecule that's in its S1 excited state is going to have a pair of singly occupied molecular orbitals, or SOMOs. Now, the SOMO that used to be the HOMO in the ground state is going to be labeled as HOMO star. And the SOMO that used to be the LUMO in the ground state is going to be labeled as LUMO star. We normally think of the HOMO as the nucleophile and the LUMO as the electrophile, but because the HOMO is partially empty and the LUMO is partially filled, there's a role reversal in the behavior of these molecular orbitals. The main point we need to remember is that the strongest interactions are going to take place between the filled empty orbital combinations that are closest to energy. Let's see how this rule applies, first by looking at the case where a nucleophile interacts with another molecule that's in its excited state. The typical levels of a nucleophile place the HOMO high in energy and the LUMO even higher in energy. In fact, the LUMO of a nucleophile is going to be so high in energy that it's unlikely to interact significantly with LUMO star. The closest energy, thus the most important interaction, will be between the nucleophile's HOMO and the HOMO star of the molecule in the excited state. Being partially empty, that makes the HOMO star behave like the electrophilic orbital. And just like we've seen before, of the three electrons involved in this interaction, there's a net stabilization of one electron. Now let's take a look at the case of an electrophile interacting with another molecule that's in the excited state. The typical levels of an electrophile will place the LUMO low in energy. The HOMO of an electrophile is likely to be extremely low in energy, so low, in fact, that it's unlikely to significantly interact with the HOMO star. That means the closest energy levels and the most important interaction is going to be between this empty LUMO level and this partially filled LUMO star. That makes the LUMO star behave like the nucleophile. What I just told you is one of the most important concepts in photochemistry. The HOMO, which we're used to thinking of as a nucleophile, in the excited state becomes electrophilic. The LUMO, which we're used to thinking about as an electrophile, becomes nucleophilic in the excited state. This role reversal of orbitals is going to turn trends that we're used to in thermal reactions upside down, and in the upcoming webcasts, we'll see several examples of this behavior.